Charles Lindbergh by Tommy Medill. Charles Lindbergh was a great American aviator who made the first solo, non-stop flight across the Atlantic Ocean. Others had crossed the Atlantic before him, but Lindbergh was the first to do it alone and without stopping. Lindbergh's feat gained him immediate international fame. The press dubbed him Lucky Lindy and the Lone Eagle. Charles Augustus Lindbergh was born February 4, 1902 in Detroit, Michigan, and grew up on a little farm near Little Falls, Minnesota. He was the son of Charles Augustus Lindbergh Sr., a lawyer, and his wife Evangeline Lodgeland. Lindbergh's father served as a U.S. congressman from 1907 to 1917. As a child, Lindbergh showed exceptional mechanical ability, and at 18, he entered the University of Wisconsin to study engineering. However, Lindbergh was more interested in the exciting young field of aviation than he was in school. After 2 years, he left school to become a barnstormer. A barnstormer is a pilot who performs daredevil stunts at fairs. In 1924, Lindbergh enlisted in the United States Army to be trained as an Army Air Service Reserve pilot. In 1925, he graduated from the Army's Flight Training School at Brooks and Kelly Fields near San Antonio as the best pilot in his class. The idea of completing a transatlantic flight was not new. In 1919, a New York City hotel owner named Raymond Ortieg offered $25,000 to the first aviator to fly non-stop from New York to Paris. Several pilots were killed or injured attempting the flight, and it had still not been done 8 years later. Lindbergh believed he could accomplish this feat if he had the right airplane. He persuaded 9 St. Louis businessmen to finance the project. Ryan Aeronautical Company of San Diego manufactured a special plane which Lindbergh helped design and called the Spirit of the St. Louis. On May 10th and 11th, 1927, Lindbergh tested the plane by flying from San Diego to New York City with an overnight stop in St. Louis. The flight took 20 hours and 21 minutes, a transcontinental record. At 7:52 a.m. Friday, May 20th, 1927, Lindbergh took off from Roosevelt Field near New York City, destination Paris, France. He landed at Le Bogart Field near Paris on May 21st at 10:21 p.m. local time, 5:21 p.m. in New York. Thousands of cheering people had gathered to meet him. He had flown more than 3,600 miles in 33 and a half hours. Lindbergh's heroic flight thrilled people throughout the world. He was honored with awards, celebrations, and parades. President Calvin Coolidge gave Lindbergh the Congressional Medal of Honor and the Distinguished Flying Cross. Lindbergh published We, a book about the historic flight. The title referred to Lindbergh and his plane. Lindbergh flew throughout the United States encouraging air-mindedness on behalf of Daniel Guggenheim Fund for the promotion of aeronautics. Lindbergh learned about the pioneer rocket research of Robert H. Goddard, a Clark University physics professor. Lindbergh persuaded the Guggenheim family to support Goddard's experiments, which led to the development of missiles, satellites, and space travel. Lindbergh also worked for several airlines as a technical advisor. In December 1927, at the request of the U.S. government, Lindbergh flew to several Latin American countries as a symbol of American goodwill. While in Mexico, he met Ann Spencer Morrow, the daughter of Dwight W. Morrow, the American ambassador. Lindbergh married Ann in 1929. He taught her to fly, and they went on many flights together, charting new international routes for airlines. Ann Morrow Lindbergh was famous in her own right for her own poetry and other writings. On March 1, 1932, the Lindbergh's 20-month-old son, Charles Augustus Jr., was kidnapped from the family home in New Jersey. His body was found 10 weeks after the abduction. In 1934, police arrested a carpenter, Bruno Richard Hauptmann, and charged him with the murder. Hauptmann was convicted of the crime and executed in 1936. The press sensationalized this tragedy, and reporters, photographers, and curious onlookers pestered the Lindberghs constantly. After the Hauptmann trial, Lindbergh, his wife, and their 3-year-old son, John, moved to Europe in search of privacy and safety. The Lindbergh kidnapping led to the passing of the Lindbergh Law. This law makes kidnapping a federal offense if the victim is taken across state lines or if the mail service is used for ransom demands. After moving to Europe, the governments of France and Germany invited Lindbergh to tour the aircraft industries of their countries. Lindbergh was impressed with the highly advanced aircraft industry of Nazi Germany. In 1938, Hermann Göring, a high-ranking Nazi official, presented Lindbergh with the German Medal of Honor. Lindbergh's acceptance of the medal caused an outcry in the United States. The Lindberghs returned to the United States in 1939. In 1941, he joined the America First Committee, an organization that opposed voluntary American entry into World War II, and became a leading spokesman for the group. He criticized President Franklin D. Roosevelt's foreign policies and also charged that British, Jewish, and pro-Roosevelt groups were leading America into war. Some Americans accused Lindbergh of being a Nazi sympathizer because he refused to turn the medal he had accepted from Germany. After the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor, Lindbergh stopped his non-involvement activity. He tried to re-enlist but was refused. He served as a technical advisor and test pilot for the Ford Motor Company and United Aircraft Corporation. In April 1944, Lindbergh went to the Pacific War area as an advisor to the United States Army and Navy. Although he was a citizen, he flew about 50 combat missions. Lindbergh also developed cruise control techniques that increased the capabilities of American fighter planes. After the war, Lindbergh lived out the rest of his life in Hawaii. Charles Lindbergh died on August 29th, 1974. Out of all the things Charles Lindbergh is known for, one of the most interesting things he ever did was pee on Mr. Patrick's boots.